So I welcome you all for this webinar on AI Foundations for Business Professionals. So as the name suggests, this is a foundational webinar on AI. Here, what we are going to do is we are going to learn about the fundamentals of AI. What exactly is AI? And when we talk about AI, how we can build an AI system, that's very important, right? We know what AI is capable of. That's for sure, everyone knows about it. What AI can do, it can do things, repetitive tasks very fast, and it can do things intelligently also. So those things we know, but how to build it, okay? What are the components in it? All these things we will touch today in this 1 hour. Considering that this 1 hour is very less amount of time, what we will do, how we will progress, okay? Let me just give you an introduction about the webinar, but before that, allow me to give my introduction first. So I'll give a very short introduction about myself. My name is Krishna Dwivedi and I am a Microsoft certified trainer. I am certified in AI 102, DP100 and various other Microsoft technologies. Specifically AI 102 and DP100, these technologies or these certifications are specific to data science and artificial intelligence. Okay. Apart from this Azure certification, I have certifications in various other domains like Neo4j, machine learning, Python, and overall, I have around 8 years of experience in training. By education, I'm a mechanical engineer, but with time, I got more inclined toward AI as I feel that it's something which is going to be a big part of everyone's life in the next 5 to 10 years, right? And it's going to change humanity, I would say, in a very big way, just like electricity and those basic technologies have changed humanity. AI is going to involve humans in and make the civilization much more at currently what we are. Okay, so this was the thing that, because of that, I transitioned gradually. It was not a sudden transition. I was into training in automation and IoT domain. And from IoT, AI is almost, it's very much interrelated. So I then switched to AI. So before we start with the actual session, let me just give you a short overview of this webinar. Okay. I don't want you to be just listening for this whole 1 hour. Okay, what we'll do, I will cover some theory at the beginning. So in theory, we will see what is AI. Okay, foundations we will see. We will see how this AI technology has evolved over a period of time. Okay, so if we know that how this technology has evolved, then only we will be able to understand very accurately what is AI. Okay, so initially, what was the first AI model that was developed and then how it has evolved over a period of time? All these things we are going to discover or discuss. After that, we will see what are the components, or I would say technologies in AI. Okay, so AI itself is not a specific technology. It's a domain which tells about building, smart systems, systems which are as smart as humans. But how to build this system? So there are various technologies. Okay, there is machine learning, there is deep learning. So all these things at the top level, we will see what are these, how they are interrelated. And after that, the most exciting part. Okay, here we will cover the responsible AI in very short. Okay, how, while building these AI systems, what are the important guidelines? Okay, so we are going to see the European Union guidelines, which is very standard and benchmark guideline, which every organization follows. And after that, the most exciting part is we are going to build an AI system right here in this 1 hour, like in maybe 15 minutes. So this will be a very simple approach, considering most of us are not from coding background. So we are going to use an user interface system. Okay, so there is a platform created by Google wherein you can build an AI system in very easy way. It's like very user interface way, you know, just by dragging and dropping, providing your data and your model is ready. So anyone who is not at all familiar with coding can also build a model. And we are going to do it today. Okay. And I request everyone along with me, you also can parallelly do it. Okay. So you just see my steps, how I am going to build an AI model. Okay. And similarly, I will give you enough time so that you can also practice it. It's very easy and very interesting also. Okay. And after that, we will take Q&A. Okay. So after covering all these things in the 1 hour, the last 15 or 10 minutes, we'll have question and answer section. Okay. So at any point of time during the session, if you have any question, I would request you to please put that question in the chat so that in between, I will just visit Teams chat and I will see the questions. Okay. Yeah, so that's all. I think now we can start with the session. Okay, so let's start with the first topic. Okay, human intelligence. When we are talking about artificial intelligence, in front of us, we have the smartest creature on planet, right? That's human. As an example, we have a lot of humans wherein we can learn from humans' cognitive capability. So first, if we want to build a very smart system, human is an example. So we need to understand how human brain process data. Once we understand that, okay, then we can just mimic it. Okay, and that's what AI defines. Okay, AI is defined as a system which can mimic, which can build a system which will mimic human cognitive abilities. Okay, so human intelligence consists of various domains, right? Human have vision capability, human have language capability. Okay, we can see things, we can extract information from whatever we are seeing. It could be image, it could be videos. So one is that capability. Second is we can engage in conversation, right? We can communicate with people. We can understand languages that we know. We can create musics, we can sing. All these are abilities or intelligence. Okay. So this is natural language intelligence that we have. We can engage in conversation. We have capability to extract data from sources. Imagine you have a book of, let's say, 100 pages and you read it in 1 or 2 days. Now, if someone is asking you what is there inside the book, you can explain all the content in book in just 10 lines, in just 2 minutes, right? So that's also we are using our cognitive capability to summarize the data, to extract the data. Then we also have the capability to store the data. So all these are human intelligence capability. Okay. And we use this to take action. So we can take decisions based on our understanding. It's also an intelligence, right? That we have. We are having now, if I sum up everything, vision, natural language processing or language processing, extracting text, okay, or gathering information from raw data or unstructured data is one capability. Then decision making is one capability. So all this intelligence, if we try to analyze and we try to copy it, okay, we will build a very smart system. So human intelligence means language intelligence. Here I have put it some examples, mathematical intelligence and interpersonal intelligence. And there are many more. Now let's see what is artificial intelligence. Okay, intelligence demonstrated by machine in contrast to natural intelligence. So we looked at human, we tried to mimic human so that we can also build a system which can be as smart as human. First question, okay, just think of it. Why do you think we are copying human? Why not other species? why we are just copying human. The first point, very important point, you all are aware that we are the smartest creature, right? That's for sure. What is the second point? Can you think of? See, the second point is, if you look carefully at human, we have the highest body to brain ratio. It means our brain is comparatively big to the body that we have, right? So if our brain is big, our body is small as compared to other animals, our brain is it's basically the source of energy for brain is very low because the body is small. We can eat less, we can process and we can store energy in less amount because we have smaller body, right? So the brain, even though we have less smaller body, you know, less energy for brain to consume, our brain is very smart, very intelligent. It means that our brain is very efficient also. It can work with less amount of energy, right? Isn't it amazing? So with to give you a rough example, I think, you know, I'm not very sure with the actual number, but it's around 24 millivolts of energy that our brain consume, you know? So low energy, less energy than that, you know, than even a mobile phone. So that's how efficient our brain is. And if we try to copy human brain, we will build system which are very efficient. So these are the two important things why we are copying human. First, humans are the most smartest creature on earth. Second, human brain is very efficient. So if we copy them, we will build system which is very efficient. Okay. In AI, the key concepts are machine learning, okay, learning from experience, and intelligent agent. Basically, all these are interrelated. Okay, so first, when a human child is born, what we do in the next 18 years? We constantly record information from our surrounding, right? In India, see, we have a limit of 18 years. Before that, we cannot vote. Right, so government has given this 18 years of limit. Why this is so? So that during these 18 years, a human is fully grown, intellectually grown. Human, that particular, you know, person can make decisions, wise decisions. So that's why we take 18 years, okay, of our learning. All the sensory organ continuously record data from environment during these 18 years, and then we, as a human, is fully grown, intellectually grown, right? So it's very important that the data, okay, is needed for the AI system so that AI system can learn, just like a human can learn from the data. In these 18 years, we collect data. So learning from experience or learning from data is one thing, very important thing, okay? So learning from data is what we call as machine learning. So whenever we build a system which learns from data, it is machine learning, right? Then we have separate branch which is very much related to machine learning, but it is called as learning from experience, and the name is reinforcement learning. Okay, so it's basically a subtype of machine learning, wherein reinforcement learning states that the system, okay, the system that AI that we are talking about knows nothing, okay, it just start learning from experience. So and very good example is a you know, application that Google has developed, right? So this it was basically a AI software that has beaten world champion in Go, okay, AlphaGo game. So that was an example of reinforcement learning. Here we don't have any data, no data, okay? So the system learns from the experience rather than data. Okay. So here, whenever we create any machine learning model, it's before use, it is knowing everything, like it is intelligent. But when we talk about reinforcement learning, when we are using it, till then, it does not have any understanding. Okay, so it's like learning on the go. Okay, so these systems become smart on the go. Okay, and these systems are smart beforehand. And then in AI, we have intelligent agents. So intelligent agents are like the systems which can do tasks automatically. There are various categories of intelligent agents. A very simple example of intelligent agent is, let's say, air conditioner, right? Air conditioner automatically maintains and controls the room temperature. There is a sensor which is continuously monitoring the temperature, and whenever the temperature increases, compressor start, then automatically cooling will start and temperature of the room will go down. So automatically what is happening? This system, air conditioner, is controlling room temperature. Okay, so these are intelligent agents. So there are various types of intelligent agent in AI. Very important topic for the future, okay, which is called as artificial general intelligence. And right now, this is something which the researchers are working more on. As of now, the most advanced AI technology that we can think of is ChatGPT, okay, or let's say Google Gemini. These models are the most advanced model, AI models, specifically large language model. But even though they are very smart, they don't have any general intelligence, or in short, consciousness, just like human. Okay, so this particular topic, AGI, tells us that how we can give consciousness to these AI systems. You know, now I think you all, you know, will think that this is something which we should not do, but I think we should not, you know, fear from this technology. Rather than, we should think of the benefit of this, you know, and then we should responsibly work toward achieving this thing. It's like whenever we are developing any AGI system, we have to make sure that there are ethics in place, okay, so that this system should not harm humans or any other creature. So AGI is basically, right now, it's an hypothetical concept. As of now, we are not able to achieve it. But as I said, it's a topic which, you know, people are working towards and trying to achieve it. As of now, what we know about AGI is how, in research, what we have found out, how humans have achieved consciousness is the way how our neurons and the cluster of neurons are attached. Okay, so in the way they are attached, so we have copied neural network. Okay, we have created a neural network just like human biological neurons. Even though we have copied it, we are not able to achieve consciousness, because the clusters of neurons that are connected inside the brain, we are not copying that. We are just copying general, you know, network, how a neuron is connected with another neuron. That's it. But we are not, as of now, we have not copied how a cluster of neuron is connected with another cluster of neuron. Okay, and that's how, as of now, scientists and doctors are telling that this is why we are able to achieve consciousness. So let's see what is there in future. Maybe, you know, in some time we'll be able to achieve it. Then we, in artificial intelligence, we have a very famous test, which is called as Turing test. Okay, what is Turing test? It's a standard test to check whether a system is AI or not. Okay, and now how this Turing test, like what is this test all about? So I will explain you with a very simple example. Imagine there is a human, okay, interacting with a machine. Okay, but human not able to see the machine because the machine is, let's say, present behind the door, and they are having interaction. After having few conversation, if this particular person or human is not able to identify that on the other side there is a machine or a person, okay, then we can say this system, this machine has passed the Turing test. Or in other words, I would say, if the machine is able to fool human, okay, so that it has the person has not identified machine. So we can say the machine is AI, has cleared AI Turing test. It's a AI system. Okay. And ChatGPT, when it was launched, it was able to clear Turing test. And that was, you know, a big headline for everyone. So, and now, what is the timeline for AGI? See, no one knows, you know, what is the exact timeline when we will be able to achieve AGI. But there is a guy, you know, very important, I would say, very, you know, this particular guy, Ray Kurzweil, has developed first AI model for humans. Okay. And this, the name of model was OCR. And I think all of us are already aware of this. Optical character recognition, right? We all have some point of time converted text in image into the text in maybe, you know, image, like anything inside the image we can extract with the help of OCR, whether it is text or, you know, numbers, anything. So OCR was the first, it is recognized as the first AI product, okay? And it was created by Ray Kurzweil. So Ray Kurzweil has just, you know, just predicted that the timeline for AGI or AGI will be able to achieve till 2045. Okay, it may be early also, it may be even, you know, far beyond that also. So no one knows. It is just a prediction by Ray Kurzweil. Okay, and when we have achieved, let's say, you know, in coming years, we are able to achieve AGI, we have to make sure that apart from just giving consciousness, we should also work, you know, at enough level or at the same level so that we can impart this ethical development. So whenever we are creating this AI models, they should be ethically sound. Okay. And this is very important. So these are some of the milestones in AI development, how AI technology has evolved over a period of time. Okay. Antiquity, like before 18th century, it was, you know, a lot of text in, there are some scriptures in which we, you know, there is mention of intelligent beings, not humans, maybe you can say aliens or any machines. So initially it was only in, you know, literature. Then when 18th and 19th century came, with the rise of mathematics, with the rise of statistic algorithms, we were able to create system which can understand data. Okay, and that's how machine learning has begun. In the midst of 20th century, we were able to create models which can play games, which can beat world champions in various games, and Turing test also. So Turing test basically was created or is given by the name of Alan Turing. And Alan Turing is the person who is oftenly considered as father of AI. So in 1950, Alan Turing has defined AI. Okay. So, and then in 1970s, 80s, it is called as Wnt, or I would say it is till 1990. Okay, around 2030 period, there was winter in AI. It means nothing much came out in these 20, 30 years. There was only one product, one major product in AI, which was OCR, as I said. Okay, so Ray Kurzweil has created this OCR model in 1972. Apart from this, there was no major development. And that is because of two reasons. One is due to lack of data, because at that time, humans were not using internet. There was no enough compute. Okay, so data was not there, which a machine can read. And when in 2010, I would say, you know, we all know, internet came to the hand of humans. We started shopping online. We did transactions online. So there was a lot of data we were generating. And then in 2010, till 2010, we were advanced in computing technology also. So we have GPUs, which can do parallel processing, you know, much faster than CPUs. So once we have these two things, then, you know, more research or more people started working in the field of AI. And after 1990s, it is, you know, AI came into picture. Like lot of people, lot of organizations started working. And then it was basically machine learning that started first. And after machine learning, advanced machine learning model, which is also called as a deep learning, started. Okay. So machine learning is like, okay, let me give you an example here. Okay. So here, in a very simple way, what exactly is machine learning? Okay, imagine you have a data, X and Y. Let me give this data a name. Say, day and sales. Okay. And we have some values. Okay. Now I have found out X is related to 10Y. Let's imagine like this. Okay. This is the relation. Okay. So it's like X is equal to 10 times of the value. Y is 10 times the X is 10 times the value of Y. So if you want to calculate the value of X, whatever is the value of Y, you will multiply it 10 times. So that's the relationship between X and Y. So just to generalize it, I can say X is equal to NY also. N is the relation. Okay. That tells us how X and Y are related. If N is 1, X is equal to Y. If N is 2, X is twice of Y. Right? So this is N. Now, if we have a data, and based on data, if we try to find out the best value of N, which can explain me the relationship between X and Y. Okay. And this value of N can only be found out by looking at the data. Right? I think you all agree with me. Okay. So if you want to find the value of X and Y, it could be anything. It could be log, it could be exponential relation also. Let's take a very simple example. Let's understand that they are linearly related with each other. So now in machine learning, what we do is we expose this data to algorithm. Okay. There are various algorithms. These algorithms give me the value of N. Once we get the value of N, let's say X is equal to 10Y. Now the job is done. You pass any value of X, Y, you will get the value of X. And this X value of X is not random value. This value is based on the historical data, right? Because N was calculated based on this data by looking at the pattern and the relationship between X and Y, right? That's how we calculated N. This is machine learning. By looking at the data, we try to find out the relationship between variables. And then once we build the model, what is this? This is a model. So once we build the model, we can just pass any value of Y and we can get the value of X. So we can do prediction based on historical data. This is very simple example of machine learning, right? Machine learning in actual is very complex. Now let's imagine or let's understand what are various technologies in AI. Okay. In AI, we have machine learning. We have deep learning. As I said, AI, artificial intelligence itself is not a technology or not a tool. Rather than machine learning, deep learning, data science, these are the tools. And with the help of these tools, we try to create AI system. Okay. So we just now we learned about machine learning. Okay. It's like finding the pattern between the data so that we can create an algorithm. We can create a model. If we have any questions, just let me know in the chat as of now. Okay, I hope I've kept things very simple. But if you have any query, let me know in the team chat. So now we know what is machine learning in a very simplified way, right? It's like understanding the data, finding the relationship between data. Okay. And based on that relationship, we can do prediction. What is deep learning? This is, we can also call as advanced ML, advanced machine learning. Okay. Deep learning focuses more on neural network. Okay. As of now in machine learning, we are not looking at humans. We are not copying humans. Okay. In deep learning, we looked at the architecture, how a human brain works. Okay, human brain architecture, how it takes input, how it processes the information, and then what is the action? Okay, how the decisions are taken. So mathematically, we try to copy human biological brain, and this tool or technology is called as deep learning. Okay, as I said, we are copying it. We are doing it mathematically. So it's an advanced machine learning technology. Okay. And okay, so here we can see various applications of machine learning, deep learning. But before that, let's spend some time, around 2 minutes, on data science. What exactly is data science? And data science, you can see, is a small part of AI. Okay, you can see here, data science is also present inside AI. So data science is very simple. See, if we are using data to train the model, to tell the algorithm, hey, look at the data and learn from it. Okay, now imagine if we have very bad data. Imagine if we have a very bad data. Okay, so imagine if we have a very bad data, so the model that will be developed will also be very bad, right? We need good data so that model can learn and identify the patterns. Okay, so it's very important to learn to have clean data with us. Now in real world, the data is not very clean. It's very dirty, right? So data science is a tool which help us to clean the data, so that once we have clean data, then we will train the algorithm on that data. Okay, so data is, I would say, it's very important part. The better model you will get only when you have good data. If you have bad data, you will get very bad model, which will not be able to do any good task. And we'll see that in the demo that I'm going to show you. Okay, so now we are aware what is data science. It's like cleaning data, removing, you know, cleaning things which are not important, which are not required by my model. So all these things, if we try to remove it, we try to clean the data. That's what data science is. Okay. Applications of machine learning and deep learning, I have already mentioned here. See, machine learning is Netflix video recommendation. So next time when you go on Netflix website, okay, or maybe application, and you can see some recommendation based on your previous watch history, immediately understand there is a machine learning model deployed, which is taking all your previous history as an input, and based on that, it is giving you prediction that, hey, you should watch this content. This is, you know, very much related to what you like. Okay, the application of deep learning is NLP, ChatGPT is one application, right? Self-driving car. So in self-driving car, we are continuously monitoring the environment with the help of camera, right? We are taking images, videos, and then we are processing it to see whether is there any object or any car in front of us or not. That's an example of deep learning. Robotics, speech recognition, there are many. These are only some. And this is here, you can see, these are some of the topics wherein lot of research currently going on. Machine vision, okay, so it's like how these deep learning model should process images, how they should process text, natural language processing, that is processing text. ChatGPT is a model of NLP domain, okay, and it is called as transform or large language model. So large language model, it's the output of this domain, which is natural language processing. Before we go ahead to see the demo, okay, let's cover some ethical part, and then we will build the AI model. Okay. So, see, there are various ethical guidelines, but one major organization, see, every organization, whether you talk about Google, Microsoft, OpenAI, these are the big organizations in the field of AI, right? They all have identified various guidelines. They have created guidelines, and which is called as responsible AI. Okay. But there are government entities also, and one of the major entity who is working very, you know, it's like very rapidly collaborating with these companies or organizations as EU AI guidelines. So European Union, you know, has created various ethical guidelines which are very standard and followed at various places and organizations. So these are some of the guidelines. So, and what is these guidelines? So whenever if any developer or any organizations are creating AI systems, these are the things that we should always think of. First is ethical purpose. So we should define various things. First and the foremost, the most important thing is ethics. Because we know these AI systems can harm if not responsibly developed, right? So ethics is very important. So EU AI guidelines, you know, European Union guidelines are, first is ethical purpose. So what's the fundamental right of a human? So AI should not violate that. Okay, so human have freedom to speech, freedom to, you know, whatever we know, right? So human's freedom should not be hampered by AI, right? That's very important. So that's a fundamental right. Okay, AI system should be created and it should be compliant with various laws and regulation. And there are two things. See, when we talk about human rights, on the other hand, there are, you know, guidelines for AI rights also, machine rights. Okay, so we should not misuse machine for doing any specific or illegal tasks. So that's also very important. And EU AI guidelines have defined that also. Then technical robustness. So we should be very much sure, you know, while when we create any AI system, we should test it thousands or millions of times so that it should not in any way it should not harm humans. Okay. So if reliable, it is very reliable, it's technically very strong, obviously it will not harm because it will not fail. Okay. Then there are additional considerations. It's like the right of human that we have already discussed, right? Values. So ethical beliefs that guides the preference and motivation of working in AI field. So there are various guidelines. I have just given you very short idea. Okay. And all these guidelines are actually covered in this particular course. Not only guidelines, I would say, in this particular course, BCS Foundation Certificate in AI, this is certification course, okay, industry approved certification code, a course created by BCS, okay, British Society. And in this certification course, this is a 4-day, you know, course wherein we learn what is AI, how to create AI systems, what is machine learning in depth, okay, what are AI agents in depth. Then along with this learnings, we also do hands-on task. We build model via Python, okay? So all these hands-on activities also there. So anyone who is not well aware or it's very new to AI, this is the course one should go with, okay? This is a foundational level course and it will build a very strong foundation of AI. And there is no specific prerequisite for this course. So even if you are not aware with Python, you can, you know, opt for this course. And because the level of coding that is used are provided in this course is very basic. So we will cover the Python also, and then we will start with machine learning. So that's all are there. And I will give you, you know, a very short idea about this certification course. So in Koenig, we can see here, you can download this course content. Okay. So this is the course, and here you can see the syllabus. Ethical and sustainable human AI, artificial intelligence and robotics, benefits of AI. This is technical content or technical module. Here we learn about AI, how to build machine learning, what are various types of machine learning, you know, and then how humans and machines can work together in future. So all these are covered in this particular course. And after this course, you can go for certification. Okay, so it's a fundamental level certification, which consists of around 40 odd questions. And if you, you know, get more than 60% marks, you will be, you know, awarded with the certificate. Okay, so here we are going to use a platform created by Google. And let me provide this link. So I would recommend you first watch my demo for maybe 5 to 10 minutes, and then you can continue and do it at your place. We'll click on get started. Here you can see we have three different types of projects. Like, we can create these projects. One is image project, one is audio project, and one is pose project. This project will identify humans pose, okay, based on the image data. Here we can give audio, okay, and teach the model to identify who is speaking. So you can provide various different person audio and train the model and then do the prediction. And in this particular project, image project, we will train the model to identify specific object. Okay, so let me show you this. We will select the standard image model. And this is the interface. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to just open my webcam. Okay, let me just close the webcam here so that, you know, here it will work. I hope it should work here now. Yeah, it's working. Okay, so you all can just see now. I'm in front of camera, and what we are going to do, let's first see what we are going to build in this particular demo. We are going to build a model which will identify whether in front of camera there is a person, whether there is a pen, or there is a cup. I've collected these three objects. Okay, and just a minute, let me just. Okay. Okay, I think my background is okay, but I think the model will be able to understand. See here, the best part is if we have a very plain background, we will be able to build a very good model. Okay, so that model will not get confused with the background objects also. So what we'll do, let me just provide some of my image so that model will understand whether there is a person or not. So we will just start our camera and we'll click on hold to record. So four samples collected. I will just move my head so that I will give all the images, all the orientation. Okay, from top, bottom, everything. Okay, so 41 samples I have given. That's it, I think. Now let's, and this is class, let's say person. Human. Okay, next class will be pen. Okay. I'll open webcam and I'll just remove myself. Let me just. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just. And then this is pen. I will add one more class. In here, I will just change it to and then I will provide an image of cup. Okay, let me just provide. I'm just showing you a very simple demo. Let's record this. Okay, now we have collected data. We know AI model learned from the data. So we have collected data of cup, pen, and human. Now we are going to train the model. Now you all can see here, it is preparing the data, and then after some time, it will train the model. So now model is learning from the data. Okay. And once the model has been trained, now you can see how the model is ready. Now see, in front of camera, I am present. It is giving me prediction human as 100%. Okay. Now let me just change it with the help of this, or maybe try this. Okay. Let me just try this pen. Can you see? It is giving me prediction as pen. Now, similarly, if we use cup, you can see here, it is identifying as the image cup, right? If I again switch back to me, it is identifying me, or you know, the object as human. So this is model, right? This is what we called as AI model. And now this is a very simple way how we can now see there is no input to the camera, so it's giving me prediction for all the objects. Okay, so the more data we give, the better model we will get. Okay, here I have just given you 40 samples. It's better if we have 1500 samples, we will get very accurate model. Okay, now here we can download this model also. See, here we have the option to export the model. Here we can click on download. Okay, and then we get the code also. And here I will show you a very now this is something which is not, you know, I have not planned to show you, but since we have around 2-3 minutes of more time before we go for Q&A, let me show you how to use this model. So here you can see, if I click on Keras and download my model, the model will be downloaded into my system. Okay, so it will convert the model, and then it will give you the model, and this model can be deployed on any application, and I have an application ready. So this is how we can download it. Now let me show you the model output. So this is my platform. This is for people who are somehow aware of any coding language. For them, it will make much sense. So just allow me a minute so that system is ready. Okay, now here you can see in this particular code what we are doing. Here we are loading the model. Okay, so Keras model, if I just show you, see, converted Keras.zip, that's what my model is. Okay, and this model I have pre-built the model, and I'm just providing the path of model here. Okay, in the load model code, and then we are providing the content which I want to read. So here let me show you the content also. So this is the image that I'm going to read. I'm going to give to the model. This is my image. Okay, and I have trained the model to identify Krishna. And you can see here, the name of this image is download.jpg. So here I've provided the path download.jpg, and I'm using this model. Inside this model, I'm sending this image. Okay, and then we are doing prediction. Now, if I run this particular model, here what we get, Krishna as class as Krishna. So in the image, the model has identified that there is a Krishna present. So in this model, I have trained, you know, I've used two objects. One is my image and one is pen. So if I upload the image of pen, the model understand and predict as pen or as me. So this is also what we can do. And this code is just copy pasted from here. Here you have to replace the image path. Okay, and you can run this particular code. Only thing is, once you download the model, you have to replace the model path here, okay, with your local model path, and then you'll be able to consume this particular thing. Yeah, so I think you all are, you know, learn from this, you know, interesting activity, what exactly is machine learning, what is AI model, and how do they identify objects. Right, so this is something in a very simple way how we can build model. Okay, so so that's all for this webinar. If we have any question, I would appreciate and I will love to answer that. So just let me know. Yeah, you can. What I would suggest to you, you can play with the model. You can, you know, give a lot of images and you can just, you know, have some experimentation so that you can learn what, how these AI model behave with different data set. So you can have various objects with you, try to give all those input to the model, and that then try to train the model and just see how this AI. So in the backend, just to give you a very knowledge, in the backend there is a CNN deployed, okay, convolutional neural network. That's the name of deep learning model. Okay, on the basis of that, these models are being trained on the data that we are providing. Mansoor, there is, you know, for Excel and PowerPoint, there is no specific model which will learn Excel data and PowerPoint. For this, there are LLM or large language model available like ChatGPT. Okay, so one of the most I would say the most important or the most advanced technology that I know is Copilot. So what you can do, you can you know, you can just test this Copilot Pro features. So in Microsoft Excel, PowerPoint, there is a Copilot. In this Copilot, you can, you know, give your input and it will automatically do, it will create PPTs for you, it can create charts, it can analyze data, Excel data for you. All this thing can be done using Copilot. Cookies are basically, these are not AI systems, these are not learning from the data. Okay, cookies are just, you know, history, or it's like they are stored. Yeah, we can have AI, maybe, I don't know, I'm not sure whether this is something which people are working right now, because but we may have many intelligent system wherein we will not require cookie in future. But as of now, there is no direct relationship between cookies and machine learning. And for the course of on BCS, you can, you know, connect with Nicholas. He'll be able to guide you how, what are different courses. BCS is one of them. There are many other courses as well. Okay, on Azure and Microsoft. So these are also very nice, you know, platforms to learn, because these, right now we build models from scratch, right? And that this model was not very great. We also saw some errors. There are models created by Microsoft, Google. These are very advanced models. So rather than, I would suggest, if you are working as a developer in some company, rather than learning machine learning, you should go with cloud technology. That will give you much exposure and much more benefit in your career. Lokesh, prompt engineering is like crafting, prompts, crafting your questions. So these AI models or large language models like ChatGPT, they have been trained on, unimaginable amount of data, like data from internet. And they know everything, like they have very good amount of knowledge. So to get best out of them, we need to create best, we need to ask good question. Okay, then only we will get good answer. So creating this question is prompt engineering. That's what prompt engineering is. Okay, we have a question. Will this mean prompt writing is there? Yeah, prompt writing is very important. As I said, see, model knows everything. Now, to get the best out of the model, it's very important to ask good question. They are not as intelligent as human. If you ask any human very wrong question, human are very advanced as compared to the current AI model. So human can give you good answers even if you ask bad question. But these LLMs are not that. They have a lot of knowledge, more knowledge than human, but they are not very intelligent or more intelligent than human. So you have to ask questions, in a specific manner to get best output. Thank you so much.